I don't know. It's been like a really interesting thing to watch just firsthand because, you know, you kind of see bands take off and do well, and you're like, oh, yeah, they're a good band, or, well, I don't understand it, they suck. But I don't know. It's one of those things. I don't think the music industry is something you can explain. It's sort of a mystery.
And are you still getting a hit around the whole fame side of things?
No, I don't take that seriously. It's kind of all just whatever. As long as I get to make my art and do it for a living, I'm happy.
How would you describe your style and your lyrics in your own words?
That's really difficult. It's really hard. I hate, like, labeling and putting things in boxes and calling it nu metal or whatever. I don't know. We are influenced by a lot of different things. We're influenced by, obviously, rock music and metal music, but also classical, and I'm influenced by some opera.
So initially, where did you learn how to sing?
It's not really a learned thing so much for me. It's just something... again, something that feels right.
Did you ever do any lessons anywhere?
I've always taken choir.
You don't really look like a choir girl.
No. I was choir president. Actually, this is like basically exactly what I look like in high school. This pain is just too real. There's just too much that
time cannot erase. So I wanted to talk about the film clips for a little bit because they're extraordinary. I mean, it's so dramatic and artistic. In one of them, you're hanging off a building, and the other one, everyone turns into ghoul-like creatures looking pretty evil. What sort of input do you have in the creative process of those?
Tons. I love video making. It's a cool break to be able to be like a director or an actor, you know, and get to do a different kind of media for art, which is just awesome. So, like for Going Under, as an example, like we came up with the concept ourselves and gave it to the director, who's the same director from Bringing You to Life. We're like, okay, well, this is what we want to do. If you can make it happen, we'll do it again. So, like all the underwater and everything, it was just really out of our own minds.
Okay, now it is time for the Famous Jules Lund celebrity interrogation. Okay, these questions have been around for as long as I've been working on the Today Show, which is about 5 minutes now. You ready? The impulse.
Is there any way to be ready?
Yeah, I don't know. They're fast and furious. You ready?
Do it.
Okay. What would you change if you had the chance to do it all over again?
In my life?
Yeah. Impulse questions. Go, go, go.
Damn it, I don't want to say... Oop. I don't want to say any bad words. That's why I do so well.
This is what happens when you feel the pressure to swear.
That's impossible. There's so many things. Everybody makes mistakes. Yeah.
What about on your journey to the top in the music industry?
I would have thought for myself more instead of listening to what other people had to tell me.
Great answer. Fantastic. Who do you admire most and why?
Bjork. At least in the industry, because she's not afraid of what people think of her at all. Like, she'll do absolutely whatever she feels like, say whatever she thinks, and people always rag on her for it. She just doesn't care.
The best thing about being Amy Lee?
You get to eat a lot of good food.
That's the best thing you get to pick out?
I don't know. I get to be an artist for a living. That's the best thing about being me.
So tell me, what is the weirdest place you've ever heard one of your songs?
In a strip club.
You often go to strip clubs?
I've been once, and they noticed me, and the stripper was like, check this out, and like, they played my song, and she pole danced to Bring Me to Life.
That was a highlight of your life.
I was so embarrassed, I left like, really, really red.